So you can imagine what we've got in store then. If that's the prize, should be an exciting first round.
First round will be the most entertaining, I would guess. I can't see him a feeling out period. Derek Millam, our referee, as we get ready. Round number one, Herman in Purcell, Kyle Brumby. And I'd expect Brumby to stay at a pretty clear distance, popping away with the jab and just fast, light combinations, trying to keep the Herminator off him. Well known, or best known, for his fight over with Paul Gallen. Good jab from Brumby. Unbreakable. Dubbed Kyle Brumby.
Yeah, Brumby's just keeping the Herminator on the end of his jab here, which I think is the wise choice. He's a big boy. Shows a striking resemblance as he comes in, as possibly to his Samoan idol, David Tua.
That he does, was my first thought as well. And there's what we'll see from the Herminator. It'll be wild. And Brumby will be, you know, he'll be aware of what he's got to do and what he's got to stay clear of. Only had one spar back, Kyle Brumby, but confident. Been in with some pretty big names, Kyle Brumby. Lost to Bolas Varga. Split points decision. And one of the Thai boxing greats, Thor Hoopman, also he lost on the split points decision there. It's a machine operator by trade.
Yeah, like the way at the moment Kyle Brumby's just keeping him at bay. Just with his jab, he's got a big left hook there. Kyle's got to be careful, keep them hands up. And that's where Herman wants to be. He wants to be on his chest and banging all over those big punches.
Good evasive skills there from Kyle Brumby. And the Herminator come out for about 1,000 of an entourage. They were everywhere. He got half a Toowoomba with him.
He sure did. And Paul Landon, Kyle Brumby only coming with himself in his corner. As the Herminator rushes and pushes him back into the corner. Brumby does a wise thing of just tying him up whilst he's in close and then getting back to his distance. Getting back on the jab. Some good combinations there.
Yeah, good combinations from Brumby, but he cops what you would call, I guess, a palm or half an inside of a forearm from Purcell. Herminator, thick as he is tall. Oh, Brumby chopping away. Here comes the Herminator.
Good sneaky right uppercut there on the inside by the Herminator. He's only a young lad. I think he's only 19, 20 years old. And he fought Paul Gallen, as some of you may have seen. And on a big stage like that, at a young age, it was a cracking first round. He ended up putting Paul Gallen down in that first round. Unfortunately, lost a bit of gas. And to Paul Gallen's credit, only being a novice himself, he ended up coming back to stop her.
Yeah, good effort that was by the Herminator. We see the end of round number one, and it was the left hook attempts from Herminator that were the standout. Brumby working the outside of the ring smartly, knowing not to get caught inside. Round number two coming up is Jamie Guy in the corner with Kyle Brumby. And obviously, Brendan Smith over in the red corner with the Herminator. Referee Derek Millam, judges Tony Kettlewell, Adam Hoyt, and Steve Marshall. Only a three rounder this one, 3 by 3 minute rounds, but up next we got a big fight, 10 3 minute rounds. Jason Nugget Cooper, Sissonthorpe at Chaiyong Gym. Here we go in round number two of this heavyweight bout. Left hand from Kyle Brumby. Herminator stalking him back with the jab to the body. And you know what he's doing. He's trying to set up the right hand over top by popping that jab down the bottom, hoping that Brumby's hands come low, which they're low already.
It's been a reserve sort of a start from Herman, from what we've typically seen from him. He's only jumped out of the blocks pretty quick normally. Maybe he's trying to pace himself and learn a little bit more back in the gym before coming back.
Well, I think that's credit to Kyle Brumby, who's not letting Herman, and again, it's not perfect for the crowd or the people at home tuning in to liveboxing.com.au, But it's smart work from Brumby. Like we said in the fight before, he does need to win the fight. First and foremost, as he eats a left hook from the Herminator, and Brumby's in some trouble.
He's in some trouble, yeah. He caught a good left hook there. The Herman hit Brumby. And followed up with a good flow with a couple of right uppercuts there that caught him. Brumby's on his bike here. He seems to be moving back and tying up when he can, which is pretty smart.
Yeah, he's doing a good job to staying clear of the shots of the Herminator, but the Herminator found the mark here in round number two. You see Brumby as he jumps out, as the Herminator fires that left hook and Brumby makes him miss. He's got to jump back in and try and at least take control or use those skills of coming out. Good left rip from Brumby, but he needs to try and jump on that. He can't just let Herman throw the left hook, jump out and do nothing as he eats a jab from the Herminator. Referee Derek Millen will have to be careful he doesn't get caught with one of those left hooks.
I reckon they don't beat him small in Samoa. He's a big boy for 19, 20 years old. It's a good right air from Bobby there down the middle.
Yeah, New Zealand born. The Herminator raised in Samoa and then moved back to New Zealand. And has only been here in Australia for 10 months.
I see he was looking for the right end and Bumby had been caught up in the ropes there.
So a bit over 14 months or so in Australia. Only been boxing for 10 months, that is, the Herminator, as he evades a jab from Brumby. And this has been a Herminator round. Round number two, first round pretty even.
And more power punches from Herman. He seems to be cutting him off a little bit better this round and getting him on the ropes and unloading a couple of good heavy shots. And Brumby's got to be careful with that left hand, staying really low. Doesn't want to give Herman a sniff of it.
Herman fought over three-minute rounds. I'm not a big fan of that myself. I'd rather see him get into at least four. We want to see him get tired.
He's doing some good attacks there, but I think he's stepping back too far and not capitalising on taking advantage of Herman having his hands back up and being in a sort of a passive defensive state. After you do your combination, step back out and do a second attack. I think if he asserts himself a little bit more, he might be able to take a little bit more momentum and take the shine off the judges and swing it in his favour.
Yeah, and I don't think it would be too hard to work out what the Herminator is going to do in the third and final round. Starts off popping the left jab. Herminator, as he's done for the first two rounds, he just prods away. Good head movement from the Herminator.
There's a good combination there.
Oh, he launched himself, the Herminator!
Jeebus, he's nearly gone out of the ring. Look out for the corner, I think it's Marlon Toby.
It is Marlon Toby.
Big Marlon Toby was nearly cleaned out by the Herminator.
He showed some good evasive skills himself down there, Marlon Toby. Well known as a journeyman, but certainly showed some skills there in the blue corner as the Herminator just come missiling at him.
The place over to one of them, got to be at least 110. Oh, good right hand.
Beautiful right hand counter there from Kyle Brumby.
And we've been fortunate enough to be with our president, Angelo De Carlo, another promoter from Brisbane. Happy watching the fights up here and up in Caboolture.
He's trying to steal our hot dogs, that's what he's doing. Well, I'll tell you, two guys who wouldn't mind stealing the hot dogs, and they're in the ring at the moment, the Herminator and Kyle Brumby.
Kyle Brumby landed some good shots there on Herman as he was leaning over in the clinch.
He's had a better round this round, Brumby. No power behind the shots, but just a few evasive, fast hands, I should say, few fast punches from Brumby. Herminator looking to come over top of the jab of Brumby. As we said, up next, the IBO Asian Pacific title, Sissonthorpe Choyong Gym versus the local man, Nugget Jason Cooper. To pretty close to the end of this fight, heavyweight bout as Purcell comes flying over the top, followed by a left uppercut. It was the right hand from Brumby that spurred on the Herminator.
Oh, oh,
big body,
big body shot. Are we going to see Brumby retain his Queensland title? You think Purcell could knock him out in his last round of the third round?
I think Purcell, he'll be trying his best, but Brumby's...
Whoa, good right hand. He came through the good David to the left hook, but to his credit, Brumby stepped back and countered with the right hand.
He's certainly entertaining, the Herminator. Mightn't be pretty to watch at times. Oh, the left hook from the Herminator.
Well, they're chopping right hand over the top in the clinch.
Brendan Smith in the corner, really cheering on the Herminator. Marlon Toby, Jamie Guy, doing their best to cheer on Kyle Brumby in the blue corner.
The Herminator's coming after him. He sets it, the ball is caught him in the left hook.
And a counter from Brumby. And there it is, the third and final round. We would have been good to see a fourth round because that was the most entertaining of the rounds so far. Kyle Brumby in the blue and the Herminator. Herman N. Purcell in the red. The Queensland title is safe with Kyle Brumby. Herminator needed a stoppage to steal that off him. But it will go down to the judges' scorecards. Adam Hoyt, Tony Kettlewell and Steve Marshall.
Yeah, the three-round heavyweight fight. It reminds me a little bit of the Super 8 competition that was just completed over in New Zealand with Big Carly Mean taking the prize. Be interesting to have someone like that over here with the likes of Lucas Brown.
Yeah, we had it down in Melbourne recently, and I think more of it, hopefully the promoters, there's a couple in the room here, Angelo DiCarlo, Adam Wilcox. Hopefully those guys jump onto that because it's certainly a great concept for the sport. If we're going to do 3x3-minute rounds, let's do it in a Super 8-style competition. I'd love to see welterweight, I'd love to see middleweight, and even light heavyweight.
It's a good time.
Certainly have. Anyway, we're back here in this one, and... waiting the judge's decision, and I pretty confidently can say I reckon it's going to be the red corner, the Herminator, Herman N. Purcell. But a great effort too from Kyle Brumby.
A great effort, and even though it was only over the three rounds, it'd be interesting to see how the Herminator and Kyle Brumby go over the eight rounds for the Queensland heavyweight title, and if that was playing to the favourite, Kyle Brumby with his experience in boxing.
Yeah, definitely would. But although in saying that, Herminator looked good over three rounds. He was still punching at the end of the third.
Yeah.
You would think it would go in Kyle Brumby's favour, but in saying that, Kyle Brumby didn't really let the combinations go that he probably could have over that three-round distance and kept Purcell off him. But easier said than done for you and me up here eating cookies. Shuffle right. Work down there in the ring here at the Queensland State Equestrian Centre.
Big Herman comes over and sees Brumby's corner. I'm sure he would have been a little bit apologetic for not going, for not taking him out.
That's for sure.
Yeah, I think that'd be a worthy clash in the domestic scene, especially up in Queensland. I'm sure the people wouldn't mind seeing a couple of heavyweights, Brumby and the big Herminator.
I think put Herminator in any corner, anyone will want to watch it.
Yep.
Here we go, as Derek Millen has got the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, Judge Tony Kettlewell has scored about 28-29-28. Judge Steve Marshall has scored about 28-29. And Judge Adam Hyde has scored about 29-28 by split decision.
Well, there's a victory for Kyle Brumby. I must eat my words. I thought it was going to go to the red corner, Herminator, Herman N. Purcell, but it's not. It went to Kyle Brumby. And credit to him.
Ladies and gentlemen,
it was a tight fight. Three rounds, very hard to get a lead away to really you know, be a confident decision given when you only got three rounds. It's certainly, I don't like the concept myself. I'd rather see at least four.
Yep.